today we're going to be doing a fantastic little painting. There's not very many colors on this painting, mostly just blue, black, and white. And it should be very easy to follow along at home. So let's just dive right in. Okay, first we're going to start off here with a little bit of blue. We're going to drag some whites over in there. I love getting the palette all messy. We're going to drag some whites over here into blue. Make a nice light blue color for our sky. I'm going to start off. I'm just gonna do these little crisscrosses. Let's just start right up here, just like that. Just like that. We just do these little crisscross strokes this way. That's how you get all your different textures up in the sky there. All your different little textures. Different colors and light coming through in different places. Go ahead and drag some of this blue down here. I'm gonna use a lot of paint for that. Get some of that old blue off this brush here. Cleaning the brush. This just kind of gives the indication of clouds. Not too light, not too dark, just kind of some texture back there. Just kind of some texture. A few little indications in here, maybe some hills. Just take your dry brush, just brush straight up. It'll start to look like little trees. It's amazing what you can do with a dry brush. We don't really know what's back there, and we don't really know that we care. A lot of people like to do this with a fan brush, but I like the straight brush. We're gonna start just kind of dropping some trees in. Right here. Just some sort of little doers. Kind of look like trees. They like trees. And remember just to go straight up and down. There's little indications of some trees in here. If you want to put a little bit of detail in here, that's fine. You can do that. This is your world. This is your world. We're going to have this tree line here just come right out into the middle. Whenever someone sees your painting, they'll think it's a very interesting painting. It looks like there's a lot going on here, but really, just a bunch of lines going up and down. And you can just kind of make it go away into nothing. Maybe put it up right out there too. Maybe put a big old tall guy out here with his little friends. And then you're gonna clean your brush. I like cleaning the brush. Drag a little bit more snow and just drag it right up in there next to those trees. And if you drag some color out of there, that's fine. That looks like little shadows. Just looks like beautiful little shadows. Turn around, make it look like it's sort of falling down a hill right here. It'd be fun to go sledding on that hill, wouldn't it? Shoot. You want to take your knife, grab just a little bit of blue and a little bit of white. Just kind of come from back in there and maybe we'll have a river. Nice river. Shoot. Maybe this river hadn't made up its mind yet where it wants to go. Another little stand of trees come right out here. Throw a little bit of dark in there. These are going to be a little closer than the last tree, so as you get closer, you want everything to be a little bit darker. Bring some snow up into these trees here. Any color you pull back just looks like shadows. Anything you pull, ever paint anything you don't like later on, just paint over it. Put a little tree right on top of it there. A little drop some limbs in there. I think all trees need a friend. Just like all people need a friend, they're no different. He's kind of leaning in because he likes to look at that river. And just drop in your little indications of some branches there.
And this here's a video of a little squirrel for some reason.
In here next to our tree, any color you grab is just shadow. Doesn't matter. We're gonna put a big old tree right here. And this here will test your bravery. I wasn't sure where to put him. I'll just put him right there. It'll make him real dark. Almost black. Just like his big brother right here wants to see the river a little better too, so we're just gonna drop him. Just like that. He's a little skinny guy. He's kind of shake the trees out of the paintbrush. They're hiding in there. Just hiding in your brush.
And I think with that, we've got ourselves a completed painting, and we're certainly glad you could join us today. And God bless, my friend.